We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who will be fronting the grid. Taylor, Hamilton, and...
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. Great qualifying session. Are you feeling safer ahead of the pack? It's been a great qualifying session for you. Are you going to carry that momentum into the race? I've heard rumours that you're interested in moving to this team. Is there any truth to that? Appreciate your time.
I think we can call that a successful qualifying. We should be in with a good chance in the race.
This is it then, race day in Spielberg for this year's Austrian Grand Prix. The grandstands were a sea of red in 2019 thanks to the commemorative hats in honour of the late great Niki Lauda, who took home victory of course back in 1984. And it's a sellout crowd once again here today. It's one of the shortest laps on the calendar today then, with seven rights and just three lefts, making up the 10 corners of this high speed circuit. Turn two is barely a corner at all. They'll be flat out through there, a left-hand kink into the uphill braking zone of turn three. Turns one, three and four are all potential opportunities to overtake. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Taylor lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Perez, Leclerc, Sebastian Vettel, and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Ocon, De Vries, and Lance Stroll, Sainz, Fiat.
Hello, can you hear me, Dad?
Going.
It happened a couple races ago.
The start sequence will begin as soon as the grid has formed. Be ready with the clutch.
Yeah.
So far. Will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
So good. It's been good so far.
Reducing our overall capacity. The more charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop.
Oh. Screwed that up a bit because I looked at my phone.
The teammate behind is 8.2 seconds. Behind, the gap to the car behind is 2.1 seconds. They're on old softs. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 7.3. Approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Is 2.9 seconds. We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. Tire condition is still looking good. Now, red box racing this lap. Expect to see some rain about 10 to 15 minutes from now.
Oh, why is my controller bugging out?
Is coming in for a stop. Leading our teammate by 15.6 seconds.
sucks.
We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Expecting rain in around 10 to 15 minutes.
Need to win this. I need to win it. No mistakes. Don't bring the safety car out. Oh God.
Of fuel left. This is your final lap of the race.
Yes.
Just amazing. Well done.
Finally, a good race.
Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success? Well, this was a real team victory.
victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment and really executed the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently. It's clear to see that they put in the work and they should be proud of the victory they secured here. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Taylor increases their championship lead. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
Daniel Ricciardo certainly impressed me today. An incredible performance.
It's time to check.
There you go, race highlights. Yeah.